Say hi.
Hi.
This is Nora and Mommy's show.
Yeah.
And
I am from Nora Kids TV.
Yes, from Nora Kids TV.
So. And I live in my mom's house with her. Of course I'm five.
Of course.
And I made my videos and I'll put it some on YouTube. And I never own.
I love you too, baby.
My dad is coming home.
Yep. He's coming home from work.
Yeah.
So Nora was up all night coughing, and she's staying home from school today. So I have a little bit of extra time to get ready, and I thought I would join the makeup filming fun and just show you guys what I usually do in the morning.
Well, I get ready for school.
Yeah, Nora's usually getting ready for school when I'm doing my makeup, but. And she's staying home. I started with this toner from Clinique and moisturizer. And today I'm using the Porefessionals primer because it does a pretty good job of minimizing my pores and a really good job of mattifying.
And would you like to see my new dog Fitz? And when we got him, I was getting in the car.
Our new guard dog Fitz. So I'm trying this Dr. Jart's BB cream because I got it for a sample from Sephora. I forgot to wet my beauty mark. That's okay. Fitz likes to go under the bed. And that drives us crazy. So we're just happy he's under something else. So this is my makeup sponge. I just wet it and squeeze it out so it doubles in size and helps evenly distribute the product. This is really all I use to apply foundation or BB cream. I like this one. It looks like it's a good match for my skin color and tone. And that's not bad coverage. It's so hot here. It's foundation breaks down like crazy sometimes. So I would be happy if this worked out and I could wear this every day. What's he doing, babe? Oh, good. Put him on the bed.
Oh, Fitz. You are so heavy.
He weighs 5 pounds. Don't carry him around, though, right? Because you don't want to hurt him. So when you pick him up, just put him right onto the bed.
Yeah, he's so heavy.
He's so heavy.
Yeah. No. I need a book. Excuse me.
That was a big burp. I heard it all the way. How are you feeling? Feeling better, kiddo?
Yeah.
So for my brows, I use this Bare Minerals loose powder. And I don't really have a great brush for it because I like to use all my angled brushes for my liner. But I have this old e.l.f. eyebrow kit that I use the brush for. So I really just fill them in, and when I'm done with this, I use an eyebrow gel to set it and control my somewhat crazy eyebrow hairs. What's Fitz doing? Oh, he's just chewing on his ball.
Yeah.
Yeah.
He always does that.
He does.
And. Go crazy like
oh wow. crazy outfits.
Power bites in case you noticed. And he's a chihuahua. And my favorite teacher is, do you know who it is?
Yeah, of course, it's Miss Van Reese.
Yeah. And Miss Van Reese loves Sears.
And Nora's teacher has a chihuahua that looks a lot like Fitz, but she's a little bit bigger. And the last time we went out of town, she watched Fitz. So it was adorable to see both of them. Yes, Ev.
Did you even notice, guys, that Miss Van Reese's dog is called Olive? Like the food olives?
Hey, have you ever had an olive?
No.
Oh, I bet you like it.
I don't like.
How do you know you don't like it if you haven't tried it?
I don't like peas because I tried it.
Oh, so anyway, this is a fun tip, I guess. This was the round that I used for my toner, and I just keep it on my desktop because I always make a mess, and so I just clean it up like my eyebrow toner.
And it's dirty.
Yeah, no, it's dirty. So I'll throw it away. For my shadow primer, I like the same thing Maggie does. I also have this MAC paint pot, which I like too. It's thicker and provides a really good base, but I don't know, I feel like it's a little finicky, like you have to use just the perfect right amount or else your eyebrow or your eyelids will look like snake skin. It keeps it on good, so I guess it does its thing there.
How do you know it would look like snake skin?
Because I've done it. What kind of eyeshadow should I do today, Nora?
I don't know. Maybe yellow?
What's it smell like?
Look what I'm gonna choose.
Tell me. The purple?
Wait, my first one.
Oh, okay.
Will it look scary on you?
No. So this is just the Too Faced Chocolate Bar palette. It's a great palette. It's got everything you need. The smaller matte chocolate chip palette, and I love this one, but I like the shimmery violet, which I think I'm going to do on my lids. Yes, Ev?
It's recording that black thing too, isn't it? Is that a holder for your phone?
Oh, let me see what you're talking about. That is... What is it? Like a picture frame holder, so you can put your picture frame on the desktop. And use that white chocolate. And you just want to use like a flat packing brush for your eyelid.
Are you using that black?
And you want to do, like a base color. And then everything that you put on after this will blend into this one. Makes it hard to blend if you don't have a base on. And this also helps set your eyeshadow primer. No, babe, I see him. He's out in the living room.
Bye.
Bye.
I'm going to get Fitz.
Oh, okay. I'm going to go in like a fluffy brush. For my crease color, I'm going to use a salted caramel. And so, you just start on the outer edge and then work it through the crease.
Mm.
You gonna rest up a lot today, kiddo?
Yes! Is it all finished?
Nope, not yet.
Are you showing up all of your makeup?
Mm-hmm. So, I have other fluffy brushes, but I'm just gonna keep using this one to do a little bit of a darker color and do that milk chocolate. Hey, bub.
Hey, bubba.
What's Fitz doing?
Fitz bubble.
And just kind of go over, maybe a little bit lower. You're so silly. Whoa. Help him up, babe.
Okay.
He didn't quite make it.
Hello. Help him up.
Something worth mentioning is your brush is all dirty like this. They have this brush cleaner that you can just spray on and like wipe onto a paper towel, or I use a washcloth so you can see how dirty it is, and I just spray it. It's like just cleans the color off so that tomorrow I can use this brush again without getting that same color all over. So you can see how clean it is. So I'm obsessed with that. So you wanna use another kind of like flat packing brush. Okay, I have this one that you can use. I use it for like on my eyelids and also under my eye if I do shadow under there. But yeah, I am gonna use this Candied Violet. So you just want to pack it on there, that purple one we talked about, remember? And then just pat it on.
Ooh!
Yeah, it's not looking very... You like that one?
Yeah.
It's not looking very pigmented, so I'm going...
I think it's going to look pretty on me.
You think it would look pretty on you? So I'm going to spray it with some setting spray.
Can I spray it on you?
No. That is not on me. I can't find. Oh, it's hiding back here. So, I just really like the mist on the Smashbox. It's priming spray and setting spray, but I mostly just use it for this. So when you spray setting spray on there, it makes it apply more pigmented. You could just wet the brush too, but I am too lazy to go back to the sink. So setting spray is what I almost always use.
Yeah, and Mommy's going to work it. I'm staying home.
Mm-hmm.
Because I think they call my friend Colton. His name is Nana Jackson. He's at school.
Mm-hmm.
And I miss him. And I'm like this.
Yeah, because how many days was Jackson out of school?
One.
Oh. Well, hopefully he'll be back to school tomorrow, too.
He was there yesterday.
Mm-hmm.
Look what I'm doing.
Okay, dude. That's not polite for the video.
Sorry.
Like with a 5-year-old.
Sorry for tooling.
That's okay.
I need to toot again. I'm gonna go in the devil room.
False alarm?
What? What?
Then you had to toot again.
I didn't.
Sorry,
I thought I did.
You thought you did, but you didn't. I am going to use the same brush. And put a little of that salted pink caramel under my eyelid. Or my lower lash line.
Can you peel my iPad?
Can I do what?
Can I peel with my iPad?
Yeah, sure, babe.
Bye! Full salon! and I'm gonna play with my iPad now. Bye. See you later.
She cracks me up. Now I'm gonna go in with a fluffy brush. Excuse me, I'm gonna use this one and do some blending. Move my crease shade. And so you can see in the comparison of right to left, the difference in blended and not blended. But it doesn't look as harsh on the right as it does on the left because it's blended in. So I'm just going to wipe this packing brush off a little bit and go back in with the champagne truffle. It's like a little pink shimmer. And I'm just going to go right down the center of my lid with that just to add a little more highlight and dimension. So again, this is like this chocolate bar, Too Faced chocolate bar palette is like a neutral palette with a couple pops of color. But if you are really into color, then do I have the palette for you? I'm going to slam it. Urban Decay Vice Reloaded is my favorite palette. I love it. It has so many like super pigmented vibrant shades. This asphalt or asphyxia is like a iridescent purpley pink, and this hot pants is a really nice pink. It's just a great bold palette, and you can even make a full look with that. These laced for your lids, suspend for the crease. I guess even anonymous for your lids, laced and suspend for your crease, and then, yes, babe.
Mom, would you love to expect to hear the ABC song?
Sure, go ahead.
I'm gonna turn it on.
So for liner, the Stila Stay All Day Waterproof is my favorite. That's a little too loud, babe. But I'm out of my brown. I'm holding on to it. And I bought this like midnight blue, but I hate it. It like never dries. And then when it comes off, it's super difficult. So I think I'm just going to use my little miniature black Stila. So I can do a wing on my right eye, but not the left, so you will not see that from me because I need more practice. Oh, babe, I love you too. Yeah, sweetheart. You want a kiss? Love you, boo.
Yeah.
H-U-G. You want a hug? Hold on.
H-U-G.
Yes, I heard. Hold on a second. So, I don't know. Maybe somebody can help me. Am I doing my left eye wrong? Like, this one is so easy, and then this one's, like, backwards, and... Hey, let me get that hug. Come here. I love you. I'm just checking the time. So my lower lash line, I got that shadow smudged. Oh, I'm sorry. What did you say? Say it again. So I like the Jouer cream eyeliner in brown. Wait for what? That I just lined my waterline with. Wait for fits?
Yeah.
For what?
For him to go.
I don't tightline the top because.
Wait for him to go.
I don't like the way it feels, and it just slides right off, and I feel like I put myself through that for nothing. I think I have a...
Mom?
Yes, babe?
Wait for fits to go.
Oily lids, but... Pop?
To go. And then...
Nice.
And then wait.
There's two O's in poop.
Hello.
And I'm gonna finish up pop. Oh.
To go poop.
I guess I should just stop putting it in my eyes. I have this Tarte Shape Tape that everybody loves, but I can't. It's too thick and I feel like it makes me look like it's creasy. I've tried using more, less. So I have this old standby, this L'Oreal Instant Age Rewind. Is it L'Oreal? Oh, Maybelline Infinite Age Rewind. It's too pink. You can see. I'm just gonna use this guy. Still damp. To blend it in. And then I usually do my, you know, my foundation or in this case BB cream first. I used to do my eyes first, and I don't remember why I switched. I'm sure there's a reason, but I like to do the, what's it called? Under eye concealer afterwards, so I can kind of clean up around my edges.
Here's my iPad case. My iPad case. And here's what we learned about. Alphabet, but mommy's doing makeup. So I'll see you later, guys. Out of the video. Bye!
I already have my contacts in, but I feel like I need like a magnifying glass. Because this magnifying part of my mirror is like, you know, too distorted until you get like an inch away from it, and then. What can you do an inch away? Alrighty. So, I set it with this Clinique loose powder. And a dry beauty sponge. I like this one because it has like this sharp point. So you can really get in there under your under eye. And so I just kind of bake my under eyes, but also kind of bake my entire face, because when I use a brush to apply the whole thing, I feel like my skin texture just looks terrible. But when I press it in, I'm going to brush the excess away. I really like the way it looks. I have this Tarte creamy powder foundation. I got from Ulta. Bought it online when they were doing their 21 Days of Beauty. So it's pretty cheap, but it's the wrong shade. So let me take that back and get the right one. Yes, my love? M-A-I-R, what's that? M-A-I-R-O. Mario? No, it's M-A-R-I-O.
What?
What are you telling me about Mario for? Or are you telling our friends? Why are you talking through your iPad? So I just use... So my skin texture still isn't perfect, but
Mom?
Yes,
look. Look what I'm gonna do.
I hit my brush on the mirror. Don't. Don't what?
Don't.
Did I use eyebrow gel?
Don't do this.
Y-A-W-N. Don't yawn. For bronzer, I really love this Too Faced Milk Chocolate Soleil. This is like a deluxe sample they sent me when I bought something else. And I love it. I'll have to buy more when I hit pan.
And
so I go back and forth between using this like fan brush for some bronzing and using more like this kind of brush. But today I'm feeling this one, so...
You do.
I do love it.
No, you.
Yeah, I don't love it.
You
do. Oh, I do love it.
Guess what, kids?
What?
Well,